Hey, welcome back to the series that we've been doing on Red's Taylor's version. I've been going track by track to see if I can find a deeper meaning within each of the songs. Today we're on track 15, which is titled Starlight. Before we get started, it might look like I'm in a big Red Taylor's version mood because of this giant nose sunburn that I have. So we'll just have to ignore that. But let's just get straight into Starlight.
I said, oh my, what a marvelous tune. It was the best night, never would forget how we moved. The whole place was dressed to the nines, and we were dancing, dancing, like we're made of starlight. Like we're made of starlight.
Let me pull up the lyrics, that way we can follow along. The first part, which is actually the chorus, apparently says, "Oh my, what a marvelous tune. It was the best night. Never would forget how we moved. The whole place was dressed to the nines, and we were dancing, dancing like we were made of starlight." So that kind of makes me think of a wedding a little bit, just because of the way that they described how they were dressed. Because it did say that they were dressed to the nines, and I kind of think of a very nice event, and weddings is the first thing that comes to my mind, but I guess that could also be like a school dance, or, I guess just an extravagant event in general. And then for the part that says we were made of starlight, that kind of makes me think of a comet or a shooting star, kind of, because it feels like maybe electrifying or it's a once in a lifetime thing. And she's kind of describing the way that they interact with each other as something out of this world or something. I know that might sound a little corny, but that's kind of my first thoughts with this. But let's just keep listening. Summer of 45, or that the person was 45. Either way, I'm a little confused, so we'll probably just have to keep listening.
They were night at the window, we were 17 and crazy, running wild, wild. Can't remember what song he was playing when we walked in. The night we snuck into a yacht club party, pretending to be a duchess and a prince. And I said,
okay, so we're gonna have to go back and read whatever's kind of going on here. That verse says, "I met Bobby on the boardwalk, summer of 45. Pick me up late one night out the window. We were 17, crazy, running wild. Can't remember what song it was playing when we walked in. The night we snuck into the yacht club party to pretending to be a duchess and a prince." So my first thoughts with that is that maybe it's one of her made-up stories, but kind of from what I understood, or I thought I understood, was that she really didn't start doing that until around folklore. But I do know that she did have a song dedicated to her grandpa on folklore, so maybe this is also about him, and maybe it's just describing his life in a different perspective than the other song that she gave us before, because there's no real way to make the summer of 45 kind of make sense to me. The only thing I really know about the summer of 45 was I'm pretty sure that's when Japan surrendered, and that's kind of what caused World War II to end. But I really don't think that had really any significance on her sneaking into a yacht club party and pretending to be royalty. So let's just keep listening on this one.
And oh my, what a marvelous tune. It was the best night, never would forget how we moved. The whole place was dressed to the nines, and we were dancing, dancing, like we're made of starlight, starlight, like we're made of starlight, starlight.
I will say that I really like the production of this song. I can't really pinpoint what I really like about it, but it kind of just makes me want to nod my head along, even though I kind of just don't know what's going on with it. So I guess it's a good sign.
He said, "Look at you, worrying too much about things you can't change.
Okay, so let's read the second verse of that. It says, He said, look at you worrying too much about things that you can't change. You'll spend your whole life singing the blues if you keep thinking that way. He was trying to skip rocks on the ocean, saying to me, don't you see the starlight? Don't you dream impossible things? So with this, I'm just going to kind of follow the story of the song as best as I can. And since in the first verse, it kind of talked about sneaking into high-level events, maybe one person in the party, the girl in the relationship, is kind of worrying about the repercussions that come with maybe what they just did. And then it says you'll spend your whole life singing the blues if you kind of keep worrying about those things. I feel like I should also be keeping a blue counter in a Taylor Swift song because we all know that she will use blue in a song. But then with the part about don't you see the starlight, I'm still following the comment or the once in a lifetime feeling that you get. It's kind of like lightning in a bottle in a way, because maybe, again, they're sneaking into these events, so maybe they're imagining their lives being like that one day, and they're saying, like, if we keep dreaming this life or manifesting it, it'll happen for us, and then we're going to be sitting back saying, like, we did dream the impossible things that came true, but let's just keep listening. Okay, so shout out to people that have big families. Definitely don't imagine that being my life. If I ever have children one day, I think 3 would be enough before I would maybe go insane. So if you have a lot of siblings or if you have a lot of kids, more power to you. But the main reason why I'm laughing is because I'm still thinking about 1945. And it's like, what else was there to do, honestly, besides have children? And then I know I kind of talked about World War II. But if you know about war, usually at the end of a war or during the war, there is a boost in the economy and there's actually a baby boom. So I wonder if this song has a little bit of historical accuracies. I'm pretty sure there was a baby boom around that time. But actually, you know what? Let me look it up just so I can prove to myself something. When was the last baby boom? 1946 to 1964. Okay, so yeah, that's so if you're in the summer of 45, you were just a little bit ahead of the game, but again, what else was there to do? So I guess 10 kids does make sense for the song. So Starlight has historical accuracies, you guys. Okay, so the production element that I really like is the guitar. I think I finally figured that out because it seems like a little bit of a guitar solo right now. What a marvelous tune. It was the best night. Never would forget how we moved. The whole place was just to the nines and we were dancing, dancing. Like we're made of starlight, starlight. Like we're made of starlight, starlight. Like we're made of starlight, starlight. Like we dream impossible dreams. Like starlight, starlight. Like we dream impossible dreams. Don't you see the starlight, starlight? Don't you dream impossible? All right, so that was the end of Starlight Taylor's version. I did enjoy the song, but I will admit that I don't think it had the same storytelling elements that are seen in folklore, just because I feel like it didn't have a super big conclusion, because I think back to like The Last Great American Dynasty, where it feels like we followed that person throughout their lives and what happened to them, and then it even have a and then that one even had a twist with Taylor's life. But this one really only told me that they met and wanted to have a dozen children, which is a story in itself. Like, it's not a bad story. It's just I thought maybe there would be some sort of, like, ending to the story, but overall, I definitely did enjoy it. But thank you for watching, and I know you guys have my back when it comes to telling me what the songs are about, so I'm really curious to see what it actually is about, because I feel like I am definitely missing something here. So if you know, please tell me. I always appreciate that, but see you in the next one.